Period, there's no score. The Rangers in blue on a power play. Anders Hedberg feeds Ron Greschner in front. Billy Smith makes the original save, but Greschner backhands the rebound up top, giving the Rangers a 1-0 lead after the first period. Early in the second period, the Rangers with a two-man rush on Billy Smith. Smith, the fantastic kick save on the shot by Mike Bachman. That Smith save seemed to ignite the Islanders. Only minutes later, trailing 1-0, Anders Kaller feeds Stefan Persson. His slap shot will beat Eddie Mio. The Islanders had tied the game 1-1 after two periods. The Islanders do their Keystone Cops impersonation. Ken Morrow, Bob Bourne, and Gord Lane all go tumbling down. Early in the third period, game tied at one. Bob Bourne circles the net. He'll feed in front to Dennis Potvin. Potvin rips a wrist shot past Mio. The Islanders had taken a 2-1 lead. Leading 3-1 midway through the final period, the Islanders put it away. Bob Bourne the slap shot, Mio the save, but Dwayne Sutter backhands the rebound home. The Islanders win game one, 4-1.
Now in the Norris Division
Final, Rangers and the Islanders. That series is dead even now. Here's the first score of the game. Back to the point for Ken Morrow. He gives the Islanders a 1-0 lead. Brian Trottier alone in front of the goal. But the Rangers came back before the first period was over. Ruud Salonen gets the goal for the Rangers. It's 1-1 into the second period on the island. Nassau Coliseum in Long Island. Denny Potvin gets the shot from the point. It goes off Mike Bossy right there. But Bossy recovers quickly and lets one fly to beat Eddie Mio. Low to the glove side for Bossy. His sixth of the playoffs for the Islanders. A 2-1 lead in the second. Jim, the Islanders have taken a two-goal lead now, but Eddie Mio, heroic in goal for the New York Rangers. One save, two saves, and watch one more before the Islanders finally poke it home. It's Gord Lane with his the goal to give the Islanders a 3-1 lead on the Rangers. Division championship now playing in the second period. We have an NHL Stanley Cup update. Dwayne Sutter will take a pass off the boards from Bob Bourne. Bourne the backhand right out in front for Sutter. Sutter pokes it home. That gives the Islanders a 4-1 lead. Now we'll pick up more on second period action with Jiggs McDonald and Eddie Westfall.
And Mac Colville.
Oh, yeah. Well, I didn't know them personally. So.
Yeah.
Well, the Cook brothers were members of the 1933 Cup. I didn't know them personally either.
I do.
Scoring to Tonelli. Back to Persson for the point. His shot hits Petorek and bounces out to center ice.
Bun Cook.
Kingston, Ontario.
Yeah.
Potvin headed up the left side out of the reach of John Tonelli. And Laidlaw headed off to this left side. Well, I guess the person who's setting that question gets all kinds of goodies. Nystrom, Gregorian, Hudson Nystrom, who was broken up at the side of the net, cleared by Laidlaw to Johnstone. Johnstone down the right side into center. Lost the handle on it, now it's cleared. Knocked out of the air by Satoric, and Potvin dumps it to center. There's Nystrom, unable to catch up with it after having poked it away from Laidlaw. Now tied up in the skates of Goring, and there's no further play.
Of course. Thank you, Diane O'Leary of Farmingdale, for supplying tonight's question. You win, of course. All kinds of goodies. Like what a Ranger fan. I'll bet a Ranger fan.
I would be inclined to agree. And the next pass is deflected off Wayne Sutter's stick. Kenny Morrow with it. Lost it to Anderson. Comes over the line with Greschner. Anderson a drive. That hit Thomas Johnson. Johnson left the puck for Bourne. Rounds it up. Backs up quickly on the right wing side. Up to center ice. Look at this feed. Bourne across the line. Around with the lady. Shoots and scores! End to end. Bobby Bourne did it all by himself. Tell me true. How dare you do? He's mobbed by his teammates. An end-to-end rush. You don't see it very often, but you've seen it here on Sports Channel from the other end, behind his own net as he generates speed coming through. You see his strides getting longer and stronger, and with this move, boom, right between the legs. He's in all alone on Neal. And
Rangers have their second of the night after a lot of hard work in the corner. Laidlaw doing the work for the Rangers to get it out in front. Lennon also assisting on the play, and Robbie Petorek is standing alone in front of the Islanders' Billy Smith. Petorek gets it through, and it's now 5-2, just into the third period. Islanders in control. Final, the Islanders are sizzling at the Nassau Coliseum. Brent Sutter, his third of the playoff, makes it look easy as he beats Eddie Mio at 6-2 Islanders. Jim, the Islanders are dominating in Uniondale as well. Butch Goring, a great pass here for Denny Potvin. And Goring pass right on the stick of Potvin. A wrist shot beats Eddie Neal. Low to the glove side. That makes it 7 for the Islanders.
Now Brent Sutter comes out of the far corner with a pass to McEwen. Lets it go from the blue line and went bouncing off a leg and wide of the net. Wayne Sutter to McEwen from the point again. His shot tipped. Neal got in front of it. Greg Gilbert in a battle for it, but the Rangers come up with the puck. And Pavlich is checked by Brent Sutter. Here's Gilbert. Back to McEwen. McEwen out to Brent Sutter. This line, usually with the two Sutters, and Bob Bourne has had another stellar performance. Wayne Sutter to Brent Sutter. Comes over the line on the right side. Brent Sutter trying to move in deep. Turns to get away from McClanahan. Came loose. Gilbert and Pavlich tie up one another. Dwayne Sutter dug it loose. Tries to come out of the corner. Now play is called, and we've got a scrap going on in the corner to the left of Neal.
Sutter mugged McClanahan from behind. McClanahan had hit him across the wrist with a stick, and it was in retaliation to that that you see Sutter now, Brent Sutter, after him. So penalty to the Islanders, Brent Sutter. You see him go after McClanahan there. And then again, he takes the hit. Watch how he grabs him from behind. Bang. Not a fair play at all. Surprise. Brent Sutter would pull that one. He was hurting. His retaliatory measure has drawn a penalty. He's gone to the Islander dressing room. Gone for the game.
Roughing is the call. He has gone with 4 points aside, and he put it right on the stick of Merrick. Merrick, a breaking pass, but there was Beck. Barry Beck off the right wing board. Kleinendorf can't control it. Gordy Lane does, giving it to Merrick, and the fans count down the final 10 seconds at the Coliseum. Merrick to Morrow. Lenny Morrow, just he likes to hold on to the puck, and that's going to do it as time runs out. The Islanders have defeated the Rangers and lead the series 3-2.
Here in Edmonton, the Oilers leading 7-0, and you'll see game 6 of that Ranger-Islander series from Madison Square Garden on Friday.
Coming up, shot is a score! There was no way that Hanlon could see past Mats Hallén in the crease.
I think that's one goal, a snapshot from the top of the circle, and it goes right by Glenn Hanlon's glove on the right-hand side.
We'll get to the puck first. Johnstone going after it again in front. Score! Watch this checking. It is paying dividends, obviously.
And the Islanders are coming back.
They're back in the game now.
Rangers got to take it to them. They've got to go at them, not go back in the defensive zone. Okay, watch Eddie Johnstone loses control of the puck, and it goes right on the Bossy stick and underneath Eddie Neal, and the Islanders are coming back now at 7-4. Another look at Eddie Johnstone. He has control. He just loses control of the puck, and it goes right on the Bossy stick and into the net. Being a little bit too fancy in their own zone right now, maybe.
Face off the center zone.
4:55. That goal will be unassisted, too, I'm sure.
Here comes Bossy with the puck. Tipped in by Gord Lane.
Left the puck for Bourne, rounds the net, starts up quickly on the right wing side, out to center ice. Look at this feed. Bourne across the line, around Ruotsalainen, shoots, he scores! End to end! Bobby Bourne did it all by a...
The scheduled material. Two very important NHL playoff games tonight. We'll start off with the Madison Square. Rangers against the Islanders. Rangers lose and they're out, and that's exactly what happened. Rangers held a 1-0 first period lead, but in the second, John Tinelli ties it right there. Then he plays a major part in the next goal as he races down the left wing, feeds Butch Goring, 2-1 Islanders in the second period. The Rangers tied it on a power play goal by Mikko Leninen, so it's 2-2 after two periods of play. In the third period, two of the better playoff shooters team up, Nystrom over to Goring, 3-2 Islanders, and they win it by a score of 5-2. The Rangers are eliminated.